Let us go into the discussion. Okay, I'm sharing the screen. Just observe, it's okay. Fine, guys. It's visible.
Yes, sir.
Fine, good. Okay, guys. Before going to discussion, okay, use this code to log in with Edmodo. Okay, for the related to assignments, anything. Okay, we will discuss. Okay, we'll have the discussion in Edmodo. Okay, this is the code for that one. Just okay. In the afternoon, I have observed only 32 has logged in. Okay, by today evening, I'm expecting everyone to log in. Okay, register for my subject, cloud computing. Okay, you guys fine, everyone? Okay, guys. Okay, guys, the first topic is scalable computing over the internet. My voice is audible to you. 59 respond, unmute yourself. Only 59 remaining, guys. Just be calm. Only 59 just respond. Number 59. Okay, once again, I'm telling you guys, whenever I ask a question with register number, they only has to respond. Fine. Okay. 59 is fine. Voice is audible to you.
Yes, sir.
Fine, good. What is your good name?
Brahmeswaras.
Okay, Brahmeswaras. Nice. Okay, yesterday what we have discussed, guys, that is first topic, that is scalable computing over the internet, and that we have discussed about scalability, that in that horizontal scaling and vertical scaling we have discussed. Okay, means in scaling means we can increase the resources or we can reduce the resources at any point of time. Okay, there are two broad categories in that one, that is horizontal scaling and the next one is vertical scaling. We have discussed already. I am recapping that one. Okay, horizontal scaling or scale out scaling means, okay, here we are able to add, okay, or we are able to remove the resources, or we can say that nodes. Okay, at any point of time, if you want to increase the resources, means we will take another system. Okay, at any point of time, if you want to release the means, we will be able to release that one, which comes under horizontal scaling. Here, new involvement of nodes. Okay. Anything, if you want to add resource means new, another node we have to add. Another node means computer. Okay, example here, I'm increasing one web server to three web servers. That is example of horizontal. Okay, coming to vertical means only one system will be there here. If you want to add any resources means we will add it to in that system only. For suppose if you want to increase the RAM size means we will take another RAM and we will place it inside that CPU only. Okay, no need to add the another resource here. Okay, another node here. Understand, guys? Okay, that is the advantage here. Vertical scaling. Here, diagrammatical representation. Okay, vertical means just adding the resources into that system. Okay, horizontal means we are adding the new nodes. Clear, guys? This is the first topic, subtopic. The next one is age of internet computing. Okay, here we will discuss mainly about high performance computing as well as high throughput computing. These two things we will discuss. Okay, any system that will comes under fall under these two broad categories only. Either it may be high performance computer or high throughput computer. Anything that falls under these two broad categories only. Okay, right. And we will discuss both in details. Coming to the high performance computing means like for suppose yesterday I told you. Okay. To process the 100 GB of video to find the core in that video, what we will do is we will divide that 100 terabytes of data into each 1 terabyte of 100 pieces. Okay, we will give it to those 100 different systems. They will search for the core in that systems. Okay, for suppose 99 systems are completed, they didn't find that core. That means we cannot say that the core is not there in the 100 terabytes of data. Why? Because there is a one more thing. One more terabyte of data is already there. Okay, we have to search. After that only we have to conclude that. That's why it is called as tightly coupled thing, guys. Okay, it is used to measure the performance of computing, guys. Here we will aggregate what we are doing here, guys. 100 systems, we are aggregating the power of the all the systems. First system, second system, all the things we are combinedly. And this way we will achieve the high performance. Okay, by using these computing thing, high performance computing, we are able to solve the large scale problems. That is the advantage, high performance. Nowadays, we are not using these things, high performance computing. Okay, guys, because it's a tightly coupled thing. One thing is repeated upon other thing. Okay, 99 systems searching is over, then we cannot say that. Another one more terabyte is data is there. After searching that one only, we are able to say that one. Okay, right? So that's why it is called tightly coupled. Example, 100 terabytes of data we're searching for the car. Okay, next one is high throughput computing, guys. High throughput computing means it maximizes the performance compared with the previous one. High performance computing. Nowadays, we are using this high throughput computing, guys. Example, guys, okay, for suppose Google search engine, if you take that one, every second, crores of people are searching in by using Google search engine. For suppose I'm searching one thing, okay, in the Google search engine, okay, in front of me, there are 1,000 lakhs of people are there. No need to wait for my request to complete with the help of Google search engine. Okay, every request is individual thing. That's what it's called as loosely coupled thing. Compared with the previous one, that is tightly coupled. Here, it's a loosely coupled. Everything is an individual thing. Okay, example here is Google. Okay, here with the help of this one, we are able to achieve the high performance compared with the previous one. Okay, here the main thing here is we are able to access the one application by multiple systems. In this way, the throughput will be increased. Example I am giving you guys, Google Gmail. Already you all are using the Gmail. Everyone having the Gmail account. Okay, every request is a separate request. And moreover thing, guys, okay, every person, I am accessing Gmail and you are accessing Gmail. Okay, your request is not at all depend on me. Everything is an individual thing. No need to wait for that one. Like the best example that comes under our cloud computing is this one. The cloud computing will comes under high throughput computing, guys. Understand, guys? High throughput computing. That will comes under this one. Right? Okay. Google search engine, here we are going to maximize the overall thing. Okay, here we are going to share the infrastructure, like Google server thing is shared by me and you guys. All are having Gmail account, right? Okay, the computing power of that Google server is shared by myself and you are all guys. That's why the throughput will be increased. The throughput will be increased. Okay, example, Google search engine. Okay, yesterday till now we have discussed. Okay, I'm going to compare those things and how the new things will be coming from this high performance computing and high throughput computing. Here you observe, guys. Okay, these two yellow parts, high performance computing and high throughput computing. High performance computer like supercomputing powers. Okay, here these supercomputing powers, we will form these grouping the supercomputing powers into form clusters. Okay, here this is a centralized thing. All these supercomputers are connected by network. It's a centralized control. Coming to here, high throughput computing, guys, it's a distributed thing. It's a distributed thing. Okay, but coming to high performance computing, homogeneous nodes. Okay, all these are connected supercomputers. Okay, form a clusters. Coming to the high throughput computing, guys, here it's a distributed thing. Myself one node, okay, yourself another node. Okay, those two persons are differently placed in different separate locations. So it's a distributed thing. Okay, everyone, for suppose I have placed one file in a Google. Okay, I have placed one file in a Google cloud. Okay, I'm able to access and you're able to access that cloud also. Sharing, file sharing. Here, we will take that one, we are group that one high throughput computing to form a network called peer-to-peer networking. Okay, I will explain this peer-to-peer also in the next slide. Okay, peer-to-peer means it's a distributed model. Here it's a distributed model. Different computers are connected to form a network, distributed model network. Okay, these two things, high performance computing, like clusters of supercomputers, and next peer-to-peer network computers, both are combined to form a computational data grids. Computational data grids. Okay, here this peer-to-peer one is peer-to-peer one is one minute, guys. Just 1 minute. This high performance computing to form, we will form the cluster of supercomputers. Okay, high throughput computing, we will form the peer-to-peer network. Okay, here these peer-to-peer networking systems will share the files. Okay, these two things combined to get the computational data grids. Computational data, it will have the properties from high performance computing as well as high throughput computing. Okay, from this one, the mainly three broad categories comes into picture, that is service oriented architecture, we will discuss this one, and the virtualization, we will discuss these things, and RFID, radio frequency identification, and sensors. Okay, these things also we will discuss, okay, in the next coming slides. Okay, whatever I explained, now it comes here. Okay, the supercomputers are replaced with the cluster of intercooperative systems. Here they will share the data among themselves in high performance computing. Okay, here all these clusters having a homogeneous computers, and they are physically connected things, high performance computers. Okay, all these will be in the at a same place, centralized location, homogeneous systems. Okay, they will share the data among themselves. Okay, this is the new thing I discussed, high performance computer. Okay, fine guys, let us proceed for the next slide, number 57. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine, super. Okay, shall I proceed for the next? Okay. I tell you guys, I will explain the what is peer-to-peer thing. Okay. Peer-to-peer means it's a distributed application. Here, different computers are connected to one single server. Okay. Workload will be shared among these all the peers. Okay, in peer-to-peer network, it's a distributed model. Here in this, the workload will be distributed among the all the different peers. Peer means it's like a system. Okay. Okay, coming to the high throughput computing, guys. Okay, I told you guys, here in peer-to-peer systems are interconnected to share the one particular file or any application. These two things. Okay, in peer-to-peer high throughput computing, we are going for peer-to-peer network. Here in peer-to-peer systems, they will share the file or applications. Like example, high throughput computers, like it's also example like cloud means different person will connect into the server, or that is a third party location. We are able to access those files or any application. Okay, here myself is accessing that cloud, and yourself is also accessing the cloud. Those things will be in different globally distributed locations, form a computational data grid or data grids. Fine guys. Okay, more or less we can say that high throughput computing, okay, like cloud computing means different people are accessing from different location to a centralized server, like clouds, Amazon Web Services we are going to access, means okay, that will be in the third party location I am going to access, and some other computer, some other company is also accessing the same things. Okay, like it's like a application share or file sharing, all these things will be provided with the help of cloud. The best example for this one is high performance high throughput computing, is like we can take that one as a cloud, guys. Clear guys? Number 59.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Fine. Mute yourself. Okay guys, I told you guys, these two things are combined to with different new paradigms. The three paradigms comes into picture. I told you the in this diagram. Okay, these two three paradigms, that is web services, or we can say that service oriented architecture, from that output is web services 2.0. okay, next one is from virtualization, by using virtualization the internet of clouds come into picture. Okay, next one is internet of things. These three are the broad categories. Okay, we will discuss all these things in the next slides. Okay, three new computing paradigms. First we will discuss about SOA, service oriented architecture. Okay guys, service oriented architecture means it's a normally if you take IRCTC website, right? Okay, we use this IRCTC website for ticket booking, that is one web service. Okay, service oriented architecture, anything, any task, okay, that will be represented in the form of application, that we call them as a service oriented architecture. Like for suppose by using IRCTC website, I want to know the status of a particular that code, that one call them particular number will be there, right? What is that number? I'm not getting that one word. By using that number, we are able to search the cities allocated, the waiting list is there or not. We were able to find out that one. That is one particular example for service-oriented architecture. Any service that will be available through internet, that we call them as a service-oriented architecture. The example for that one is Web 2.0 service. Okay, here I am taking the example as shopping site. Okay. Selecting a one item, that is a one web service. Okay, what we will do is different clients are connected to a one server. Okay, whatever the request that will be generated from the client will go to the server. The server will process that request and give the response back to the client. This is that will be followed in the service oriented architecture. Like example, if you take IRCTC, if you take that number to search seat number is allocated or a waiting list is there, we are able to find out. Okay, we will send that number that will be went to the IRCTC website and process that one. Okay, the seat is allocated or already waiting list is there, that will be shown and that result will be back to the client. In this way, any service like a shopping site, that is on a service. Likewise, to knowing the weather details of outside, that is also one web service. 1 minute, guys. Any sir, excuse me. Okay, any service that will come under fall under this web 2.0 example, shopping site or weather information knowing from outside or IRCTC. Cities allocation are not finding out, all these things. These are the supports of the services. Overall service IRCTC means it will do lot of things. In that one, if you take the support of the service, that we call them as a service oriented architecture. Okay, here client will be there, server will be there. All the data will be at the server location. The client will use the request to the server. The server will process that request, and the result will be generated in the server that will be sent to the client. The client will observe that result. Okay, this is we call them as a service oriented architecture. Example, we can say that shopping site or weather information knowing, RCTC website. Okay, right, all these things comes under SOA. Okay, radio frequency identification. Okay, this is also one come output from that one. Okay, yeah, here radio frequency identification uses electromagnetic fields, guys. You understand. You will have the credit card, right? Okay, if you went to the petrol bunks, okay, no need to give that card to that person, just they will have the device. Okay, you will place on above that device, it will take the information from that one. How it will take, guys? It will take the radio waves. Okay, the device will send the radio waves to the your credit card. Your credit card will have the electromagnetic field information. Okay, these radio waves will capture the electromagnetic waves and take the information from the credit card. Okay, and the amount will be deducted from your credit card. That is one best example. Radio frequency waves sending and information gathering from the electromagnetic field, guys. RFID. Okay, this is also one of the new technology. Internet of Things. Here we will use Internet of Things for that one. Just the credit card information. No need to swipe that credit card or debit card with the device. Okay, just we will place above that device. Okay, it will send the radio waves to the your credit card, and it will capture that information with the help of electromagnetic field reading from. Okay, that will be again sent to the device. In this way, it will track the information. This type of application where you can use it to, like, if you want to track and manage inventories or people or like a computer equipment. For suppose you have ordered some device from Flipkart. Okay, they will attach some tag. Electromagnetic field information, they will attach that one. Okay, it will travel from Hyderabad to your location. How it will travel, guys? It will went to first Gurgaon warehouse, after that Hyderabad warehouse, each and every place the information will be tracked with the help of radio waves. It will send to the radio waves to that object. Okay, from that it will take the information from the electromagnetic fields and identify. Okay, we can attach it to the cars, and we can attach it to different inventories, books, computer equipment. With the help of these mechanism, radio frequency identification mechanism, we are able to track the different persons, things, or people also we are able to track. It only made you just two things, that is electromagnetic field information that will be there in the device object. Okay, to capture that one, what it uses? It uses radio waves. It uses radio waves to capture that information that is stored in the objects. Okay, how the information will be placed? We will place the information with the help of electromagnetic fields. For reading purpose, we use radio waves. Okay, for storing the information, okay, by attaching the tags, we use electromagnetic fields, guys. Clear, guys? Okay. 57, clear?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Next one is global positioning system, guys. You all know about this global positioning system. You all familiar with this global positioning system, guys. Okay, what is a global positioning system? With the help of this global positioning system, we are able to track an object, okay, that is there in the any place in the universe. Okay, in the earth. Okay, in the earth, if any object is there, we are able to identify with the help of global positioning system. Global positioning system, which uses satellites that will be there in the upper part of the sky. Okay, with that help of those satellites, we are able to track the objects. Okay, here the first, this one is primarily used by American Army 1960s at least. After that, it is available for the common people also. Okay, previously, guys, you know, guys, India Pakistan war in 1967 at that time, okay, India will have the friendship with the US. You all know, guys, that, right? I will give the best example of GPS. Okay, but at that time India want to know, okay, what are the things that is there in the Kargil area, okay, from the Pakistan side, how many bunkers are there, how many devices, how many helicopters are there, something the India want to know. But at that time India won't have the satellite information. Like at that time US will have that information. Satellites, they are maintained at that time by USA. India asked about that information about the Kargil location, what is the Pakistan capacity there. At that time, the US Army, they refused to give the information. From that point onwards, India has concentrated mainly to send their different satellites to the sky. Okay, and now India is sending lots of more of satellites for different countries also. Okay, right? With the help of this GPS, yeah. Ma'am.
1 second.
Ma'am, tell me.
Ma, somebody has logged in with some dirty words. Entadi chavandi first entamma. DRK Babu annaru. Malli nemo danni chavandi first A4. Manoj, entani? ఎందుకు అలా చేస్తున్నావు? నేమ్స్ అలా రీనేమ్ ఎందుకు అలా చేస్తున్నావు? చావండి ఫస్ట్ ఏంటి? మా కొంచెం మీరు మరి ఎవరు అది అలా
చావండి అసలు మా చేంజ్ కూడా చేయలేదు మేడం.
నీ నంబర్ ఏంటి? మళ్ళీ డిస్కనెక్ట్ నీ నంబర్ ఇక్కడ డిస్ప్లేలో వెళ్ళిపోయింది.
నేనున్నా మేడం, నేను మాట్లాడుతున్నా కదా మేడం. నేనే మేడం, ఎవడ కనెక్ట్ అవుతున్నాడు మేడం.
మనోజ్ బాబు చెప్తున్నా నీకేనే కదా
ఎవరికైనా. అయ్యో మామూలుగా ఇన్ జనరల్ గా చెప్తున్నా, నీ గురించి అని కాదు నానా, ఇన్ జనరల్ గా.
అరే మనోజ్ అని ఎవరికి తెలుసుదిరా చెప్పు, నీ ఫ్రెండ్ గా తెలుస్తుంది, అది ఒకటి గుర్తుంచుకో. సరేనా? ఇప్పుడు మనం ఎవరైనా డిస్టర్బ్ చేసామంటే గనక మనతో పాటు 94 మంది డిస్టర్బ్ అవుతారు. మనం గుర్తుంచుకోండి, నువ్వనే కాదు
చెప్పొచ్చు సార్ వేరే వాళ్ళు.
అదేనా మనోజ్ బాబు, నువ్వనే కాదు ఎవరైనా సరే
అన్నట్లా ఎవరో మిస్టేక్ చేస్తున్నారు. అది
చూసుకోండి, ఆలోచించుకుంటారా? ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏం తప్పేం జరగట్లేదు, ఏం తప్పేం చెప్పని చెప్పి క్లాస్ లో ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేసుకుంటున్నాం. ఓకే, ఎందుకు అలాగా? రైట్, మనం ఇప్పుడు వేరే వాళ్ళు డిస్టర్బ్ చేయకూడదు, మన పర్మిషన్ చేసుకుంటే
వెళ్ళిపోవాలంటే ఏదైనా చాట్ అయినా రికార్డ్ అవుతుంది, అంతా సేవ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. సో మీరు కూడా చక్కగా ఎందుకు మంచిగా ఉంటే పాజిటివ్ గా ఉంటే సరిపోతుంది కదా. నేను నిన్ను ఉద్దేశించి అనట్లేదు, క్లాస్
అందరినీ ఉద్దేశించి చెప్తున్నారా మనోజ్, నువ్వే కాదు ఎవరైనా సరే. ఓకేనా? రైట్ గైస్, ఓకే. You all know about GPS, guys, global positioning system. With the help of this one, we are able to track. Okay, we are able to track any object in the earth. Okay, first it was used by United States, okay, by Army. Next it comes to the civilians. The next one is Internet of Things. It's a multidisciplinary thing, guys. It involves not only computer science, it includes mechanical things and digital computing, like electronics. Okay, by combining all these things, we are able to form different unique identifiers. With the help of this one, we are able to transfer the information over the internet. Like, best example is smart AC, guys. Smart AC, okay, before coming to your room, you're able to on the AC from some other different location. Like, for suppose you are about to start from office to home, okay, you want to be your room should be cool, okay, what you will do is your AC is connected with the internet from the office location. Before starting from office, you're able to do that one, like just one click, you're able to ask on the AC from some different location, guys. Okay, guys, right? Right, clear. Example, best example is smart AC. We are able to access from a different location that is connected to internet. This AC is connected to internet, as well as your phone is also connected to the internet. You are able to operate from your office location to your AC, okay, by help of internet, guys. Here it is just multidisciplinary things, means as well as your computer science knowledge and devices, mechanical knowledge as well as devices, as well as digital machines knowledge and information, like involvement of mechanical department, computer science department and ECE department. They both combined to form a different unique identifiers. Okay, these are connected with the internet. Okay, how you are able to access means from anywhere location we are able to access. Okay, without human interaction, we are able to access the AC from different location. Guys, clear? These are the three broad categories. First, what we have discussed are here. Okay, radio frequency identification. Okay, the diagram system, this is the diagram. The first one is web 2.0 means service oriented architecture. Next, virtualization means clouds. Next, RF sensors. Okay, next one is the new thing, that is computing paradigms distinctions. Computer paradigm distinctions. Guys, still now everyone clear? Number two, Satsai. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Super. Okay, the next one is computing paradigm distinctions. Here we are going to have the, when the time goes on, okay, different computing paradigms come into picture. The first one is centralized computing, next one is parallel computing, the third one is distributed computing, the fourth one is our computing, that is cloud computing. These three are the different computing paradigm distinctions, guys. First, olden days we have used centralized computing. Okay, next we went for the parallel computing, means two or more processors will be there, they will run concurrently. The next one is distributed computing, to increase the performance. Okay, like a high throughput. How we will get the high throughput? With the help of distributed computing. Okay, the last one is the cloud computing. These four things we are going to discuss in the coming next slides, guys. Okay, centralized computing, parallel computing, distributed computing and cloud computing. Okay, these four characteristics we are going to discuss. Centralized computing means what is that one? Parallel computing means what is that one? Okay, distributed computing and cloud computing we are going to discuss in the next, that is computing paradigm distinctions. Let us go into the first one, that is centralized computing, guys. Everything will be there at one location only. Here in that one location, different computers will be there. They are attached to it by LAN. They are attached by a LAN. Okay, here the computer itself control the peripheral devices. Like all these computers are connected by internet, as well as like peripheral devices like printer, like scanner. Everything will be also connected to this in this network. From one system also we are able to control the printer. From the next system also we are able to control the scanner. Okay, everything we can control from the systems. Because these are all are connected to LAN. Okay, this is the best example of olden days. We have used this one. We call this as centralized computing systems. Okay, centralized computing. Clear, guys? Everyone, centralized computing means everything will be at one centralized location. Okay, here all these computers are attached to by network. Like in this network, the peripheral devices also attached, like a printer, scanner, input output device, different things will be attached. with the help of any one system, we are able to control the any peripheral devices, guys. That is the advantage. Okay, resource sharing will be there with the help of this LAN, centralized computing, guys. Okay, next, coming to the diagram here, all the systems are connected to the different networking device, like PHA. If you observe this diagram, how many systems are there? 6 systems are there. They are connected to internet. Okay, these are connected with a printer and hard drive, storage purpose, and file sharing, centralized file server. These are all interconnected, guys, from any one system. For suppose, if you have from this system, you are able to control the printer. Okay, if you can give any document for printing from this device, or likewise from this device, likewise from this device, from any device, we are able to control that. Okay, this is called, we call them as a centralized computing. Okay, next one is parallelized computing, guys. Parallelized computing. Okay, parallelized computing means with the help of this one, we are able to achieve high performance. Here, what is that? Here is a problem is there, one big problem. That big problem will be divided into small chunks, guys. Small chunks. Okay, each and every problem will be solved by different individual system. Each and every problem will be solved by different individual system. Finally, they will combine the all the works to form a solution for the overall computing. You already know that, guys. For suppose your system will have multi-core processors, 2 or more processors, then we call them as a multi-core processor. That means your system having 4, for suppose 2 processors are there, means at a time 2 processors will concurrently parallelly work. Okay, one processor working on audio and one process is working on like file processing. Okay, those two processing works are separate thing. Those things will be work parallelly. Understand, guys? These we call them as a parallel computing, guys. Means at a time 2 or more works can be done. Okay, multiprocessor means for suppose 2 processors are there, means one processor doing one work, another processing is doing another work. In this way, we will increase the performance, guys. Okay, this we call them as a parallel computing, guys. Parallel computing. What is the diagram for this one? Here is overall problem that is divided into 4 subparts. Okay, each and every subpart is given for one processor. Overall, how many processors are there? 4 processors. Those 4 processors, okay, will solve the different subproblems. Here, overall problem is divided into 4 subproblems. Each subproblem is given for separate processors. This separate processor will parallelly work and get the result. Finally, the 4 processors combined get the overall result for this in parallel computing, guys. You guys understand? Okay, number A not. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you say what is parallel computing now? A0. 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 If you won't say the answer, means that means it's a absent for you. A0 should be, your mind should be here only. Who is A0? What is your name? A0. Who is A0? Krishnaveni, ma'am.
Sir, chappandi.
A0 ka absent chesukondi.
A0 unnadu.
Adi. Whenever I have the question.
Sir, indakada varuku unnadandi.
First he said, yes, sir. He understand, yes, sir, he told. Then explain what is parallel computing means, he went away. That is why. Okay, ma'am. Okay, 1 minute is there, guys. Request is, guys, all of you has to log in with Edmodo. The code is here. Here is the code. Have to log in with this code. Okay, guys. Okay, by this end of the day, I'm expecting 95 members to be logged in. Okay, has to log in Edmodo. with this code. We will have the discussion okay, there, guys. We will have the discussion there. We will give the assignments there. Okay. Personal discussion, like mean subject discussion, will be also there with the help of advocates. Okay. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Ma, I want to say something. Yesterday, I have also shared the Edmodo code for data warehouse and business intelligence. So all of you join in that. I will share the PPTs in that and materials also. Okay, thank you.
Okay, guys. Happy Vinayak Chauthi. Okay, any information related to that one, we will get it. We will share in the groups. No, don't worry, guys. Till now?
Same to you, sir.